Hi, I'm Guy Charbonneau, and you sit inside of Le Mobile. I've been sitting in that truck for over 30 years now. It's unbelievable, and we're still doing music. One thing in Le Mobile will probably never, in that truck, never get out. It's that good old Neve. It's something about the Neve. It's, you cannot describe. It's musical. It has a sound. So over the year, Neve and Studer was really my machine of choice. Studer 800 as analog machine. I'd be in one point switch with Dolby SR, where I think it was brilliant. It sounded great. It's very musical. And what I did, I never tried to have a tape machine changing the sound for me. It was capture what the Neve does when I play it back and want to sound the same. We, for many years, was trick analog, time to time go with digital machine 48 track and kind of fight. I didn't feel proper with these digital machines. They were not sounding like the analogs, not sounding the Neve sound. Until one day, again, Studer came and loaned me a Studer machine for a Cirque du Soleil project. I lived for a week with that machine. And at the end of the week, I said, ooh, I need to buy two machines. And I bought two machines. Now we were switching between, depending on project, analog or digital machine. And over the year, again, a couple of years, maybe, I don't know, time passed so fast, 4 or 5 years ago, tape start to go away. Pro Tool become every time we need to make a Pro Tool session. We did have a Pro Tool for us when we were mixing for editing. But we were just an 8-channel Pro Tool. And at that time, I have an Apogee 8000 converter with my Pro Tool. And we liked the way it sounded. It sounded like the Studer machine for me. It was sounding like music to me, you know? And we were editing using this machine, bouncing between the Studer machine and the Pro Tool at that time, or tuning or fixing stuff and go back to tape machine. When it came time to build a full system, because now it's time to get a full 48 track of Pro Tool, we installed a Pro Tool with, like everybody else, by a Digi Design system. And we did some A/B tests, and it was kind of, something's wrong here. It doesn't, it's like I'm putting a glass up front of the sound of what I used to. And I, first thing we did with that system, we said, let's try at least something, a better clock, because that's maybe one thing in the Studer machine. The clock is great. These make these machines sound very nice and analog in a sense in their sound. So we put a big band clock to the Pro Tool, and that was already a serious improvement, no matter 48K or 96K, you know. But we're still not there. So I don't have any here now. I have my D16. I said time passed fast, and you know, maybe 4 years, whatever it is. And I went to a NAMM show, and I saw Dave from Apogee showing these converter. We like our 8000. Could we borrow an ED and the AC16 and do some tests, you know? And I got stuck. I ended up to buy 192 of these I/O. I think it's more than that, because I built another system after that with 48 more channels. And that's the history how we end up with the converter Apogee. It gave me back what this console gave me. You know, for me, that's the important thing. What I capture, I record, I play it back, it's the same. That's what I want. And I don't want it to sound different. I don't want it to sound brighter. I don't want it to sound darker, or the dimension. And that's probably the hardest thing, you know, for converter, you know, where a lot of them could sound good frequency-wise, but you miss that depth. And of course, it's not maybe every preamp or every will show you that difference, but with the Neve, and we have some Grace preamp as well. We really like for our portable system, and some Millennial preamp, and that's the combination of what I use, and it just works. You know, what I record, what I capture, what I play back. It's that's what it is. You know.